No? He will tell you, I worked hard because I wanted to change the life I had lived. Because my background was a bit terrible. I went to a primary school, not the one that I wanted, but the one that was affordable and closest to my home to avoid transport cost. I went to high school, which I wonder whether it was high, but I went to a secondary school, which was in the same compound with the primary school. I was to go to, in fact, it was called Kiadieri Primary, Kiadieri Secondary. I was to go to Kiadieri University, only that there was none, because that was the life. And so when I got a chance to go to the university, I worked hard to the point of, in physics and mathematics, getting first class honors. Don't you think I deserve my coffee? You see? And I got a job immediately. I started as a high school teacher also. And I knew life would never be the same again. As a teacher, in Nairobi, where even the house allowance was more than Waushago, I knew my life would be the best. Shockingly, after teaching for 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, and because I was still furthering studies, I found myself teaching in the university. So, mshahara isimenda juu. But having taught for a total of 13 years, 6 in high school and 7 in the university, there were no even signs of being rich. And so what I did at one point is to do so many jobs, and I was doing 7 good jobs. I was never in the house looking for money. I told you I'm Kariuki Kamau, you know, you know the association with the money, the name and the money. So I was looking for money, but you know, if you're looking money where there is no money, will you find money? I had no time. I was sleeping for about 2-3 hours, and I discovered the harder I worked, the broker I became. I don't know why. So when the opportunity came and it found us, that is why I embraced it at once. I wanted something that would change my life. And you have listened to her story. I joined accidentally, because it's not me who was being presented to, it was her. Me, I joined accidentally. But what a good accident. So we started. We worked in this business. And one thing that really helped me is the desire I had to change my life. So even when we were growing, and I remember the way colleagues laughed at me when they saw my first check of 2002 Kenya shillings, they laughed at me. And I was like, am I really doing the right thing? But you see, the desire to succeed was too much that I had to ignore them. Of course, as I moved on, now they realized I'm succeeding. You see, people will join you when they see you are succeeding. But before you start succeeding, watataka wakuangalie, ndio kama kitaumana kiumane kwako. You know? So I realized now they are joining me. And I continued building the business. To the extent that after teaching the university up to 2015, I had changed my life completely. Note this. Catholic University of Eastern Africa, where I was teaching, is a high-cost school. So even students drive themselves. And I used to have some lectures in the night. So after teaching, and the stage is quite far, you know where Catholic University is and where the stage is, Rangatarund, it was a bit far. So after teaching, and the way they have really feared this genius, you know, the way you teach things that you look like you. And now they respect me. And then now going home, they are driving, I'm busy on the road, you know? It was so shameful. And then it rains, and you can see my height, so falling is easier than for a short man. And you know, they would, you know, they don't want to laugh at me. Because if you laugh at the teacher and tomorrow there is a cut, will you pass that cut? But I was feeling deep in my heart, I'm frustrated, honestly. Of course, those who would feel for me, they would tell, stop their cars and tell me, Mwalimu, get in. And so I would start telling them, nowadays I decided to walk, you know, exercise helps. You know, the way you answer a question that you have not been asked. So it was horrible. Praise be to God that the army man brought me into this opportunity. Dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, by 2015, life was so good here that I was teaching in the university, not for money, just for the sake of teaching. I was teaching because I love teaching. Of course, you can see I'm a good teacher so far, isn't it? I was just teaching not because of money. But you see, at the Fields Band, even if you have money and you are a good teacher, you are called to a certain office to be asked some questions like, why are you late to submit the marks? And you are richer than the person who is asking you the question. Why have students passed too much? And it's because I'm a good teacher, but I have to explain, why should they pass too much? You know, there is that curve in the university. They should not fail too much, they should not pass too much, they should be somewhere. So I'm answering the question why they have passed too much, and the answer is simple, because I'm a good teacher, but that's, no one can listen to that answer. So I asked myself, what am I doing in the university? And the climax was 20th of September 2015, when we were flying from the palace of the Lost City. Was it? Yeah, the palace of the Lost City in Sun City. That's where we were flying from. It was 8 p.m. We were living in that palatial place. And when we were coming back on 20th September 2015, when we were almost 40,000 feet above the sea level, 8 p.m., my wife asked me, now that we are getting back home, will you go back to the university? And I asked her, to do what? She got a paper. She started writing some letter. Remember, I wrote her resignation letter. So she started writing my resignation letter. And coming back, I forwarded the same letter, although it was typed. I typed and presented it to the university. They were not shocked why I'm leaving, because they were wondering why I'm still there. Can you imagine? You are putting on another like this, and all your colleagues are wearing the clothes that you... Oh, sorry, professor, let me not finish that one. And from that point, I decided there are other lecturers who can also teach what I was teaching. So I stopped telling the student to look here. Now I tell them, not the students, but adults like you, we look up to Mauritius. That is what now I tell people. By the time I was leaving the university, I was earning 10.42 times what my colleagues in the university were earning as net in the university. 10.42. Oh, somebody is recording me and putting it for me to listen. Okay, thank you. So that is what can happen in this opportunity. If I'm earning 10 times what I was earning that time, don't you think I was lost in the lecture halls? And so what I tell people, learned and those who are not learned, you must decide enough is enough. And you start your journey of becoming the person that God created you to become. Why should you die poor and you were born to be a tycoon financially? Why should you die having not left this country and you are supposed to know all over the world? Today I travel about 3 and sometimes 4 times within 1 year. Why should you die? And it's never too late. It's never too late. You can always start. But you know what happens? Sometimes we get used because we were trained to do things in a certain way. So we want to always do it that way. Because you are taught Archimedes' principle, you want to continue teaching Archimedes' principle even if you don't believe in it. I was teaching logarithmic tables, which I hated teaching because I knew we never use them anywhere, but because they are in the same numbers, I still taught. Doing things because you are paid for doing them, even if they are not very important. But am I saying that we should leave our jobs? No. You, for 6 years or so, I did both, teaching the university, but I knew one thing. When I'm in the university, I'm helping other people. Called Catholic University to be a very renowned institution. Who was helping me to achieve my dreams? While I was doing the routine things in the university, who was helping me to achieve my dreams? Nobody. So I decided I will also concentrate on my future. And as a young father, sorry, Pierre today told you how many children I have. For many of you, you only know I have many. And I was like, I don't want my children to live that painful life. So I had to really build my dreams as I was still teaching in the university. So I did it. If you are too busy, being busy is really nothing. Did you know that poor people are the busiest? That time I've told you I was too busy, I did it half time with my family. Today I have all the time with my children. Come tomorrow at Intercontinental Hotel and you'll see my entire family at Intercontinental Hotel the whole day. So when the children go back to school on Monday, will they be the same now? Wale wenye walishinda tu kwa compound. See? So they are living good life. Ladies and gentlemen, it is until you decide yourself, not your boss, not your friends. You know, sometimes we are influenced by our friends, isn't it? But you must think as an individual and you decide enough is enough, I must change things. And if, you know, sometimes we do the wrong things for so long until we don't want to change. What is so wrong with if you are walking in the wrong direction and you have done it for so many years and you realize it's the wrong direction? What's so wrong with changing? If you are blind for so many years and you have 2 days to die and God opens your eyes 2 days before you die, will you say, no, uligua wapi, imi akawetho ni sinja wa yona, sasa wakati na kufa kesho, kutuwa diyo na nifungua macho. You will be excited for the 2 days. So, ladies and gentlemen, we must, each one of us here, personally decide, I want to live the life of my choice. Why should you be influenced by, and don't forget this, 90% of people are complainers because life is tough on them. Why not choose to be like the 10%? I've heard people talk nowadays at Yungayangano, the cost of flour is too high. Is that what people are saying? I've overheard, Ungaya? Ya ugali, nigani konju? Whichever. Sukari, atas kunyuangi sasa hiyo niliacha. But I have had people complaining, but let me confess before God, I never complain because when I go to buy the unga, I don't look at the cost, I don't know how much it costs. So I ask, ni nini haiko kwa nyumba? They tell me, so I buy. See, I know who I am. See, I have some money. Instead of waiting for the government to bring down the cost, which might not happen, instead of waiting for them to bring down the cost, you know what you do? You increase your earning. So that is what I did. And you know what? Today, it's so exciting that even the bank managers, just the other day, on a Friday, I was called by a certain bank at Sarova Stanley for breakfast. At I am their best customer. And I'm like, what? And you know, when we were taking breakfast, they told me, for a long time, we have not seen anybody bringing such kind of money. And I was like, thank you, New Life. Those days, the salary was getting finished before the month ends. Today, the month ends before the money is finished. Is that not a good problem? Those days, I was always at the ATM, about the 85th or that or second. I was always at the ATM to see whether they have put the money. Then the ATM tells me, you have insufficient funds. And I have worked for that the days. You have insufficient funds. Then I move around. And after 2 hours, I go back. They must have put it now. So I go back. Then I put the pin. And the machine tells me, you have insufficient funds. Then you look at it angrily. After a few hours, it must be there now. Have you ever seen these screens for ATM? Some of them are broken. It's because Kenyans get angry. No insufficient funds. And I have worked. And they forget it is not the machine that pays you. It is someone else. So today I thank God I don't go to the ATM. I will say this as I end. Today, I am overpaid. Today, when I wake up in the morning, I don't wake up to go and work to earn. Today, I wake up very early to make sure those people, and they are seated right here now, who feel they have desire to succeed, who feel they are tired of paying rent, who feel they are tired of driving cars, that it seems like they are the ones who are carrying the car instead of the car carrying them. Those who are tired of that. Those who are tired of striking every now and again. Na kunyoroshwa nyagunyo na askari. Na kukula tiangas. Na kuketi kwa rami. Those who are tired. I wake up every day so that I can help them to become president, team members, like we are ourselves just for. Ladies and gentlemen, with a lot of passion, I will tell you this before God, that we are so committed that sometimes we don't sleep. Because everybody is so capable of becoming a president team member. Everybody is so capable. Refuse to live in a box. Get out and you achieve your dreams. Look at the person sitting on your chair. Why are you looking at your neighbor? That person sitting on your chair, tell him or her, you are a president team member. Every day remind yourself about that and that it will come to pass. Nothing will stop it from coming to pass. Remember, God wants us to live the best life. And that is the life that is ahead of each one of us. But you must decide, success is not for everybody, it is for those who want success. Don't listen to noisemakers if you are serious on this journey. I believe this year, 2017, will be a year of us making steps. Senior managers becoming directors, directors becoming suppliers, suppliers becoming rookies, becoming president team members.
us from achieving that, because it is the will of God. I must stop, because when I get charged, I told you I'm a man of few words. Now I must stop. But my brothers and my sisters, count on us. Piero said, teachers tried to discourage her. I refused to be discouraged. And the people who will discourage you are the people who don't know anything about what they are discouraging you from. They just want you to remain at the same, you know, level, status quo of complaining. Uchumi ni mbaya. Ni Yesu atarudi atusaidie. But when you decide to fly, decide, I am no longer part of you. I am gone to success levels. May God bless you so much. May God bless you so much. Let's be meeting in the beaches of the world, Mauritius, and all over. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Wow. Thank you so much. Let's appreciate our president team members.
And for sure, I need to say no more. It has been said, well said, and we are so happy because we have the best of the president team members who have the best of interest at heart for every person who is seated here today. Want to go to the next session? And my envelope is coming so that I can be able to see who is who. Where are my world team members? World team members, where are you? Oh, they decided to sit on this side, eh? Okay, let's see. Okay. All right.
And I'll start with number 10. Are you ready for number 10? Are you ready for number 10? Our world team member, we have read them the top 8. Okay?
Our world team member number 8. It's none other than Charles and Christy Mira. Let's appreciate Charles and Christy Mira as he comes up in front. Our number 8 president team member. Okay, Charles and Christine Mira.
Koma kofi mzuri jamani. Congratulations, Charles Mira, for a good, for a job well done. Number 8 World Team Member 2017 Superstar Team. Okay. Are you ready for number 7? Number 7 world team member is Elizabeth Wanjiru. Let's appreciate Elizabeth Wanjiru. She's not with us this afternoon. So we're going to number 6. Are you ready for number 6? Are you ready for number 6? Our world team member number 6 is Cherotich Rindemta and Richard Kipkemoi. Let's appreciate Cherotich. Thank you, Pierce. Let's appreciate Redempta doing a good job. All the way from Kericho. Kericho. Are we here, Kericho? Let us appreciate Pierce there. I mean, Redempta. All right. Now, top 5. Coming position number 5, world team member, is none other than Samuel and Madris Dacanio. Let's appreciate Samuel and Madris Dacanio, world team member number 5. Position 5. Congratulations, Mantris and Samuel Dacanio, our world team members. Number 4, position number 4. Are you ready for number 4? Number 4 position goes to Lydia and Ruth Mwesa. Congratulations, Lydia Mwesa. That is number four position. World team member. Position number three. Are you ready for number three? I'm looking at this side because that is where the world team are seated. Number three goes to Grace and Caesar Gitagu. Let's appreciate Grace and Caesar. Good job, Grace and Caesar. And congratulations. Congratulations, number three, Grace and Caesar. Okay, number two. Are you ready for number two? The defining moment for number two is now. Our number two position goes to Kennedy Kiango and Rebecca Onyego, all the way from Molo. Congratulations, Kennedy and Rebecca. Good job. Congratulations. Let's appreciate them once more. They have done a good job to be number two. Congratulations, Kennedy and Rebecca. And now to position number one, World Team Member Superstar 2017. Position number one goes to Isaac and Purity Ndungu. Position number one. Congratulations, Purity and Isaac.
Way back in the month of May, but I was just seeing the messages as ignoring them, as sometimes many of us do that. But finally, the messages was too much.
Nilikuwa nimesoma sana, that's why I'm a lecturer. And sikuwa hatukuwa na pesa. We had very many problems of finances in the house. And therefore, I believed and I knew that this opportunity would change our lives. And we started immediately. I kept inviting him, and when I was inviting, I was making sure I was telling our president to talk to him so that he can agree to join. I thank God, he joined, he saw the opportunity, and he joined. But I remember the time that he believed the opportunity was